Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can fill out or complete a non-fillable form. So for example, if somebody sent you a form that you just can't click on, there's nothing you can fill in, there's no box, there's no cursor, nothing, then I'm going to show you a technique for how you can overcome that and fill out this form. So I'm going to use this form here, but let's just say, for example, that somebody sent you a form in a different application or a different piece of software, and you just couldn't do anything with it. So let's just go onto the internet a second and recreate that scenario. So we've just got some random forms here from Google. You can see there's hundreds of different forms here. They're just example forms. Let's say, for example, this form here had been sent to you. So I can't do anything with it, clearly, because it's just an image, basically, which is effectively what a non-fillable form is. It's like an image. And you just need to get it back to the individual. You don't need to necessarily use their software, but you can send it back as a PDF. All you need to do is take a screenshot. So I'm going to take a screenshot on a Mac, which is Shift Command 4. There we go, we've taken a screenshot. And now this is also a screenshot of another form that I did in Word. So let's just take that form out. So now you've taken your screenshot, we need to insert it in here. So just click insert, go to picture, click on the drop down and select picture from file. And you can see my screenshot is here. Just click on it and click insert. Screenshots are normally saved to your desktop and you can see it's now been inserted in Word. So now we need to stretch this out to fill our page, but you can see once it's inserted, it won't move. So right click on it, go down to wrap text and select behind text. And now you can simply move it about, click and drag it out so it fits your page. So we can drag it to about here. Now, obviously the background to this one isn't white, but it doesn't matter. And now you can go ahead and fill out that form in the same way that I'm about to do now. So you simply go to insert, go along to text box, click on the drop down and select draw text box. Now I can draw out this text box anywhere, doesn't matter. Let's say, for example, I want to put in my first name here. So let's just type out Lisa. And if I deselect this, you can see this text box has this black border. And if I move it, you can see it's also got a white background. So I'm going to remove both of those. So make sure this text box is selected. Go to Shape Format, go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select No Outline. Click on Shape Fill, click on the drop down and select No Fill. Now I can make this box as big or as small as I want to, and I can also adjust that text. If I want to adjust the text, just double click inside, select the text, go to Home, and then you've got your text customization tools here. I can just increase the size of that. You can also change the font in the font tools here. And then all I need to do is to move it into place. You can also use your arrow keys to move this up and down and left and right. And once I deselect it, you can see that that element has been filled in. So you don't have to keep inserting text boxes. All you need to do is copy and paste this box. The easiest way to do that is to select it, hold down your Alt or Option key on your keyboard, click and drag. Then deselect it, because you could see both of those were selected, reselect this box, and then double click inside. And once again, we just fill out the information. Now, if you've written in this text box, you can see the cursor's inside. I can't copy and paste it from here. I have to deselect the box, then reselect it so the cursor is not inside the box. Then again, hold down my Alt or Option key, click and drag. Now you can also use this for bigger sections. So I can put this down here, reasons for leaving, and then I can just type my text in. I've just inserted some random text there. And again, you can move this to the left or the right and fill that box as you see fit. Deselect it, and as you can see, that's been filled in. Now, once you've completed your form, you don't need to do anything more complicated than simply save this out as a document. So go to File, go to Save As, name your document up here. I'm going to save it to my desktop. And then down here, you've got file format. Now you can save it as a Word document. Alternatively, you can save it as a PDF if you need to send this via email. Once you've done that, you just click save and it will save out as a Word document. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.